Hiroshima. For the first time in human history, and 4 days later, another was dropped in Nagasaki. Generations have changed, and the number of people who experienced the attack of an atomic bomb has been decreasing. With the end of the Cold War, the nuclear competition has eased. The movement toward nuclear free world has been encouraged by both governments and the citizens. However, nuclear weapons still do exist in the world. We shouldn't regard it as a distant or past issue. In order to realize a nuclear free world, various rules such as the NPT were established. Five countries are considered as nuclear weapon states under the NPT, namely the US, Russia, the UK, France, and China. They are accepted to possess nuclear weapons officially because they produced and exploded nuclear weapons before January 1, 1967. 1 year before the NPT was signed by the UN. Other countries are called non-nuclear weapon states and not accepted to possess nuclear weapons. Supported by 190 countries, the NPT prevents the spread of nuclear weapons in the world by nuclear non-proliferation and disarmament. To encourage nuclear non-proliferation, the NPT prohibits the five countries from helping non-nuclear weapon states to develop nuclear weapons. On the other hand, non-nuclear weapon states are not permitted to receive nuclear weapons or the technology for making nukes from the five countries. Also, they have to accept safeguards from the IAEA when they utilize nuclear power for a peaceful purpose, in order to ensure that their purpose is not to develop weapons. To encourage nuclear disarmament, the NPT requires nuclear weapon states to try to reduce their nuclear weapons. However, the NPT has some issues. One issue we will talk about today is that there are some countries which have not participated in the NPT and are developing nuclear weapons unofficially. For example, India, Israel, and Pakistan. North Korea used to be a member of the NPT but withdrew in 2003 and has been threatening other countries. Iran participates in the NPT but is suspected of developing nuclear weapons by some other countries. The second issue is that the NPT includes some ambiguous expressions. For example, in Article 6, each member nation is supposed to pursue negotiations in good faith for nuclear non-proliferation and disarmament. However, the standards of good faith are not clear. Moreover, concrete measures to reduce their nuclear weapons are not specified. These ambiguous points of the NPT should be specified. If these points are specified, everyone will be able to easily understand the importance of nuclear disarmament and non-proliferation. They will develop their own awareness towards denuclearization, and it will be a nuclear free world.
We considered what was necessary to develop awareness towards denuclearization. This time, we focused on education about the nuclear-related problems of each country. In order to see what students thought about these problems, we took a survey. We asked our friends to answer our original questionnaire by posting it on Facebook. We got 23 answers from 30 countries. The US, Germany, Thailand, Australia, Hungary, Malaysia, Singapore, France, Egypt, the Netherlands, Spain, Bulgaria, and Japan. Of course, this data does not cover all of what they learn in each country. These are just examples. Our questionnaire consists of 4 questions. Here, we will introduce 3 of them. The first question is on the last page of your handout, so please see it later. The first question is, are you interested in nuclear weapon-related problems? 74% of the students chose yes. The second question is, do you think nuclear weapons should be abolished? 74% of the students chose yes, and 26% of the students chose no. In this question, we requested the respondent to write their reasons as well. Here, we'd like to introduce some of them. The reason from a German student who agrees with nuclear abolition was, for a safer and happier world where all people can live together without starving each other. A Singaporean student answered, it has a lingering effect that affects not only the people at the time in which it is used, but all future generations. Next, I will share some opponent reasons. A French student said, some dangerous country can make nuclear weapons secretly, and if they use it one day, we will not be able to handle it. So keep, but don't use it. A Spanish student wrote in, while I understand that the use of them would be awful, the existence of them has prevented many wars since the end of World War II. Through this question, we found that those who agree with nuclear abolition think that nuclear weapons are not necessary to make a peaceful world, and they focus on terrible physical effects of nuclear weapons. Meanwhile, the people who oppose nuclear abolition focus on the power of nuclear weapons as a deterrent to war. The third question is, do you think schools should offer education about nuclear weapon-related problems more? Indeed, 95% of the students chose yes. From this question, we found that young people are deeply interested in these problems, and we think they need more productive education.
Japan has already contributed to the international education for nuclear disarmament and non-proliferation. The United Nations Program of Fellowships on Disarmament is one of them. By this program, the experts of disarmament from developing countries get opportunities to deepen their understanding about the field. During the program, they visit many places, including Hiroshima and Nagasaki. After taking part in this program, a lot of participants work as diplomats in the field of nuclear disarmament and non-proliferation. The United Nations Disarmament Conference is another example. In this program, top experts of disarmament from all over the world have discussions. Japan has hosted this conference every year since 1989. As you can see, most of these projects are for experts. In our opinion, projects for students and the public are also needed because students will lead the society in the future, and the voices of the public have the power to form a society toward nuclear free world. Today, we would like to propose making a subject, Heiwa, in which students learn about the causes of the past wars and discuss possible approaches to a peaceful world. Heiwa means peace in Japanese. As Japan is the only country which experienced a bombing, we would like to spread this word Heiwa all over the world. Although many countries in the world have already studied peace studies, we believe that every child must learn about nuclear problems because it is an important factor towards realizing peace. So here's a proposal plan. First, students will learn about the tremendous damage from atomic bombs so that they can build a mutual resistance to nuclear weapons. And we believe that students should learn about Hiroshima and Nagasaki. Here, I will share some facts that we think everyone should know. When the atomic bomb was dropped on Hiroshima and Nagasaki, huge number of people were killed immediately. In Hiroshima, over 80% of the people who were within 1.2 kilometers from the high center died in one day. The main causes of death were external injuries, radiation damage, and burns. Some died instantly, and others were suffering for hours and hours before they died. This is a lunchbox of a boy who was exposed and killed by a bomb in Hiroshima. He was looking forward to eating it, however, he could not. His mother donated it to the Hiroshima Peace Memorial Museum. Probably, many of you saw it in the museum the other day.
The student also needs to study its long-term effect. The radiation effect research foundation, a cooperative organization of American and Japanese government, showed the long-term effect of the air bombing attack. According to their research, survivors of an air bombing attack have more risks of suffering from leukemia. Do you know about this authorization system? In the case, a person is recognized as having an air bomb related disease by the Japanese government, the person can receive medical benefits through this system. However, a lot of people who suffer from these diseases haven't been able to receive medical benefits because the authorization screening is so hard. It is said that there are 200,000 survivors in Japan, but 95% of the survivors haven't received medical benefits. This is unbelievable, but true. Survivors are demanding to review the standards for medical benefits authorization and radical reform for the authorization system. However, there is a big problem. It is the average age of the survivors. The average age is 78.8 now. Therefore, immediate action to solve these problems are required.
In Heiwa class, students will discuss such issues. What do you think about this serious damage? How would you feel if you yourself, your parents, or friends suffered from an atomic bombing attack? From these questions, students can exchange their opinions and deepen their understanding and their own ideas about nuclear problems. Also, they will keep the resistance to nuclear weapons in their mind, which will be the first step to lead to a future society without nuclear weapons.
should differ by their age. For example, elementary school students will learn about the physical damage of an atomic attack through using animation. Junior high school students will learn about the history of nuclear weapons, and high school students will learn about nuclear tests, treaties, and so on, through using textbook with more information and illustrations. In your handout, we included some content that we thought high school students should learn. So please see them later. At last, we are going to make our final aim clear. Our final aim through this proposal is to change nation forces towards nuclear disarmament. In order to achieve this aim, education is essential. So today we proposed making the subject Heiwa, where students can deepen their understandings and ideas by discussing our various important topics. The more people understand how inhuman nuclear weapons are, the stronger opinion against nuclear weapons they will have. Moreover, students ourselves can make action on the internet. We can share what we learned in Heiwa class. For example, making a message sound, sharing presentation movies, or something like ice bucket challenge to spread the idea of denuclearization. In doing so, people's wish will grow bigger. Eventually, it can lead to making a big change politically. Let's say that there is a politician who understands that people are against only nuclear weapons. The politician will be supported by a lot of citizens. And if the politician is elected as a leader, the country's policy will change as well. So with the war. This is the end of our presentation. Thank you very much for your kind attention. If you have any questions or comments, please.
question, and I would like to ask you, what is the first time to come to Hiroshima and see?